Hello everyone, my name is Thurudet Dupumet from Japan S1 Institute of Science and Technology, JICE. I am a representative of our research team, including Professor Jetsada Kanjana, Professor Walitong Povetnon, and Professor Masashi Unuki. Here, I would like to present our research topic is blind estimation of room acoustic parameters and speed transmission index using NTF-based CNN. Let's begin from emergency announcements that might occur in case of natural disasters, fire, violent or terrorist in public spaces like train stations, department store, office building. Emergency announcement is important related to safety of our life. For example, in poor acoustic area, for example, subway, we might hear the announcement something like this. Next example for earthquake emergency in Japan, in poor Southfield, we might hear something like this. For a better quality auditorium, you should hear more intelligible. Let's listen it again. Therefore, the sound field affects a lot in speech intelligibility, so the characteristic of the sound field need to carefully consider. Many room acoustic parameters and objective index have been studied to use as tool to assess the quality of room acoustic. The first one is speech transmission index or STI, used to predict the intelligibility from the quality of speech transmission channel. The STI represent the quality of the sound field related to perception in terms of listening difficulty in scale between 0 to 1, from bad intelligibility until excellent intelligibility. To measure the STI, we have to stimulate the signal into the test field and observe the distortion ratio of those modulated signal. The STI calculate in 7 octave band and calculate the modulation transfer function so that the output is the index between 0 to 1. Furthermore, in a time domain, impulse response can represent the characteristic of linear system. In acoustic area, room impulse response, or IR for short, is used to represent characteristic of a sound field. This figure shows the example of room impulse response measured in a real sound field. If we consider the room impulse response signal, that can simply explain in three components: the direct sound, early reflection portion, and the last one is called reverberation. To obtain the IR, we have to stimulate the test field by using the high energy impulse signal or sweep sinusoidal signal like this. Measure the room impulse response IR, we can derive the room acoustic parameter. First, reverberation times T60 is derived from the energy decay that leads from 0 dB to 60 dB. The second is called early decay times, EDT. is similar to reverberation time, but it's found that more close to our perception to reverberation. And the last three parameters are the parameter related to the energy ratio between early reflection and late reflection. The first is Doyle's sky, or D50, used to describe the clarity of speech. Center time, TH, used to describe the balance between the early reflection and late reflection. And the last interested parameter is clarity index, or TAT, is used for monitor the clarity in speech. In realistic situation in common area, there consists of people in the space, so the measure loom impulse response from the non-occupied space usually be variation from time to time, and in such realistic space, we can't measure the loom impulse response because of the take a high energy sound source. So from the equation of the observed signal, we don't know the input signal, we don't know the reverberation time. This comes up to the problem of Bly's estimation that we use from the only the observed signal in the particular area to estimate the interested room acoustic parameters. The strategy of this study, we utilize the relationship between the definition of modulation transfer function in this equation and the Schroeder IR model and the MTF of the Schroeder model shown in this equation. Also, the mechanism of the SCI algorithm that calculates the MTF for 7 octave band. From this relation of MTF and IR and the mechanism of SCI, we estimate the T60 reversion time for 7 octave band. Then we use this equation or relation to approximate the MTF and IR. Another key concept in this study, we found that the temporal amplitude envelope, or TAE, is more related to speech intelligibility. Here show the example of the TAE extract from the reverberate speech signal. Here, this is the original TAE. We can see that the peak and dip of the TAE of the original signal is for a particular point is quite high. If that signal passes to reverberation environment, the modulation depth or the peak to the depth of the TAE is smaller, is distorted by the reverberation phenomenon. From this property, we utilize the characteristic of the TAE that distorts from the reverberation in room acoustic as the input in this scheme. This is our proposed scheme. We take input from reverberate speed signal that consists of 5 seconds and sampling at 16 kilohertz. The signal decomposed into 7 octave band at the same as the mechanism of the STI. In each band, the signal extract to TAE. The TAE feed to the nonlinear mapping. Here we use the convolutional neural network CNN to map the TAE to reverberation time, the parameter in the Schroeder model. For CNN, we utilize the one-dimensional CNN to convolute the tenable filter with the time domain TAE. For each band, the relationship between reverberation time and the MTF is utilized. So for the STI, we can estimate the STI from the 7 MTF. Likewise, for the 7 reverberation time in 7 band, we reconstruct the unknown Rubin power response that's associated to Schroeder IR model. From here, we can calculate the 5 room acoustic parameter that's derived from the Rubin power response. These are the experimental setup. In this experiment, we synthesize the IR by varying the reverberation time from 0.3 to 5 seconds with step size of 100 milliseconds. Then modulate with the different speed of my Gaussian noise. We separate the most of them for train the conventional neural network CNN and the rest for evaluate at the simulate room. And for the validation of our proposed scheme, we utilize the 43 realistic Rubin power response. The reverberation speed is the convolution between the IRs and 10 Japanese speed signal. Here, this is experimental result. The x-axis represents the parameter calculated from the known IR. The y-axis is the estimated value. The diagonal dashed line represents the optimal the ground truth. The closer to the diagonal dashed line, the more accuracy. The proposed methods in blue and red from the simulated and realistic room are more closer to the diagonal dashed line for both the reverberation time and speed transmission index. And the root mean square error compared between the ground truth and the estimated value provide much more accurate. The result of the energy ratio parameters CAT, D50, and TS, we can see most of the results are closer to the reference and diagonal dashed line. Even though they have some outlier, we will consider in the next study. Before the end of my talk, let me conclude this study. This study, we utilize the concept of the MTF, that's the modulation distortion of TAE for 7 octave band, and use the CNN map to the parameters of the Schroeder's IR model, then derive the 5 room acoustic parameters and speed transmission index. So from these estimated parameters, it can provide the benefit for many areas of speech application. That's all of my presentation. Thank you very much.